that statement is saying, right?
Like
the child that he was,
yes.
It had made him the man that
he is
yeah.
on this very day.
Yeah, he said, see, because if you forget where you come from, hey, you are never going to make it where you are going because you lost reality of yourself. So take one stroll through your mind and see what you will find. And you will see a whole universe all over again.
Mm. That whole last verse, I feel like when that second verse was written, it was yes. more of, it's time to close the song
yeah.
and reflect upon it.
You see, Dr. Mabila Mathebula was supposed to have been here. But we had a bit of gremlins. We had Eskom. And then we had all the things that thought they were going to be against us. But we are here.
We had Eskom first.
See, Dr. Mabila Mathebula, I can see you're wearing warm. Eh?
Yeah, well, I think Ngaruvenda bari unaka ufana udiviwa.
Yes.
The way I'm looking at you, you are so beautiful to an extent that I think that saying will now be archaic because you look so beautiful.
So they're saying for the benefit of Vision and people like Vision. Now, archaic. What is archaic, Vision?
A cake.
Mm.
I don't know.
Not a cake.
I know. That's what I thought of first because there's two words. There's two words there. A and cake.
You see something that is an old fashion, right?
Yes.
Old style. Something not necessarily obsolete, but you know, something that is no longer in use. It has become a cake. You see?
Vintage.
Why are you vintalizing?
Because vintage is not too old. Not necessarily not used, but it's old.
Dr. Mabila Mathebula.
Hey, Stan and Vision.
Mm. He's not too far off from the answer, but I like the fact that at least the one thing that we need to get him to do is to be able to read books. Eh?
Yeah, he has to read book because, you know, reading does more than, you know, develop thoughts. It liberates the mind.
Mm. So it develop thoughts and it also liberate the mind. And you know the interesting thing,
yeah,
you know, you see,
your mind will be liberated, yeah, once you start reading books.
You see, Dr. Mabila Mathebula today started with very interesting words, right?
A cake,
right? And develop, right?
Yes.
And liberate. Do you know if you can put those words together, you can come up with something so very profound? So I don't know what he ate today, eh? But I'm sure he didn't eat the dictionary.
No, I think I know what he had.
Yeah.
A cake.
today, I don't know what is happening, but there are some forces
against us
that we are trying to sort out now.
None shall prosper.
None shall prosper, Dr. Mabila. None shall prosper.
No. You know what, Stan and Vision, what I like about today is that although we are not high tech today,
yeah.
we are high touch. And I think that's very important.
Okay. We are high touched, yes.
Okay, yeah. Mm.
So, Dr. Mabila Mathebula, because today you were supposed to have been here from, you know, half past three, right? And due to some forces or circumstances beyond the scope of our control, right? We didn't get to discuss because there was a topic that we wanted to discuss with you. But before we go to our today's topic, we need to discuss it. We were talking about friends that, don't tell you anything up until the last minute. And also friends that tells you anything, even if they are going to buy just a pair of jeans, they will just tell you about they're all their businesses to a point where it also become oversharing. Now, my view and Vision's view were slightly aligned, except that Vision was saying sometimes it just so happened that you know, you don't know what brings the subject up, but sometimes you might be in the middle of the conversation and you remember, by the way, I wanted to buy a pair of jeans, you know, and then you then tell your friends, you know. It was just one example though, Dr. Mathebula. So we want to get your views with regard to that, right?
Yeah, well, firstly, I think we need to define what a friend is.
Mm. Yes.
When you talk about a friend, I think it's two hearts but beating as one.
Mm.
And then when two hearts beat as one, you share almost everything. And I'll actually go to an example. Mm. The Bible says that Abraham was God's friend.
Yes.
Which simply means that when he was excited, he would actually share everything with God. And when he was sad, he would share everything with God.
Yes.
And the same applies to God. When God was sad, he would share with Abraham. When he was happy, he would actually share with Abraham.
Mm.
You know, and that's the purpose of, you know, of friendship, of pouring out your heart and saying exactly, because your friend must actually know exactly what is going through you.
Mm.
You know, when you are happy, he must know. When you are sad, we must know.
Mm.
And then also, there are no hard and fast rules that prescribe how friendship should be conducted. You know, it's something that actually happens really spontaneously.
Mm.
You know, and
naturally, yes.
Yeah, it's something that actually happens, you know.
Mm.
And also, a friend is there to guide you. And I'll go back to Abraham and God.
Mm.
When Sarah told him to expel, if I have to use that word, you know, Hagar and Ishmael,
yeah,
you know, he was reluctant to do so. Mm. And then God said to him, listen to the voice of your wife.
Mm.
You know, at times, you know, you need a friend like that who's going to say to you, you know, listen to the voice of your Sarah, you know, listen to the voice of your wife.
Mm.
You know, you need that type of a friend. And a friend is not a person who's going to, you know, it's not only going to be a fair weather friend. A fair weather friend is a friend who's there when life is rosy.
Mm.
But when you go through challenges and controversy, he's not there, or she's not there.
Mm.
Now you need a friend who will actually call a spade, and not a silver spoon.
Very, very interesting thoughts around the issue that we're talking about, Dr. Mabila Mathebula. Now, the interesting thing about that is that this topic is going to go on up until the end of the show. So the number is 062-450-8619. Let me repeat, 062-450-8619. You know, just so that you can send us a voice note, an SMS, or even a WhatsApp on that number. But right now we are talking to Dr. Mabila Mathebula, and then today we focusing our lesson from Tata Mkulu, you know, because Tata Mkulu, we often think that human wisdom come either from the West and the East. So, and it is very important to also listen to the wisdom that come from Tata Mkulu, Dr. Mathebula.
Yeah, but well, I think the Tata Mkulu issue we'll discuss next week when I come to the studio.
Oh, okay.
And I think let us actually focus on the question of friendship and how friendship develops.
Yes.
Firstly, friendship, you know, it's not something, you don't actually go to someone and say, I want to be your friend. It doesn't actually happen that way.
Mm.
It's something that happens organically. You know, you find yourself, you know, being friends, not because you plan to be friends, but you actually find that your minds, they meet and mate. And once your mind meet and mate, it becomes a friendship.
There's something that I'm gonna let me confess this thing, Vision. I was the previous night, right? Prior to my meeting with Dr. Mabila Mathebula. So I was reading a book written by Ellen Wright, ne? Ellen White.
Yeah.
And it's called The History of Redemption, right? And then the next day, I met Dr. Mabila Mathebula. Guess what he had? The same book.
He never told you to read the book. You just...
No, I had the book. I was reading the book because I do have the book, right?
Yes.
I can even show you. It is upstairs there by the office. So,
okay.
So
And that book is out of print now. Mm. And when we met with Stan, the book was already out of print. Yeah. Now it means that Stan and I have got community of view or community of interest.
So we are like-minded people. Mm. So friendship, Dr. Mabila Mathebula, is you don't apply for it. You don't go into the advertisement for a person who's looking for a friendship, and then you look at somebody that thinks can fit your profile and say, this one will become my friends, right?
Yeah, you don't do that. Mm. And also, friendship with the opposite sex, mm. it might actually start off being platonic.
Mm.
And then from there, it can actually develop into a passionate relationship, starting from friendship. Now, from friendship, so many things can happen.
Mm. And when you say somebody is my friend, you are not just saying this is my friend just for the sake of saying it, but we are talking about something that is actually coming within you.
Yeah, absolutely. You actually find yourself that you are friends, not because you, as I said to you initially, not because you planned to be friends, but you find yourself to be friends, like you envisioned. You are my friends, but I never planned that one day you'd be my friends. But
yeah.
I actually find myself in a friendship, and something that actually happened, not wittingly, but unwittingly.
Mm. You okay. see, not wittingly, but unwittingly.
Yes.
You see, Dr. Mabila Mathebula will have to explain, not wittingly, but unwittingly,
You see, even made me kick things again.
Dr. Mathebula, vision decide today is kicking things.
Yeah, I can see he's hot today. because I know, because it is his birthday, his girlfriend's birthday, but I actually understand. I also understand the excitement.
So unwittingly, vision, does it have anything to do with holy or unholy? Not holy as H. Like, how do I explain that, Dr. Mabila Mathebula?
Without being aware?
Yeah, okay. Thank you. You see, this young man is it's not so bad, Dr. Mabila Mathebula.
He's very witty. He's very intelligent.
He will smile. So let's talk about the relationship that started platonic, Dr. Mabila Mathebula.
Also something that started platonically is that you become friends, and then from there that friendship develops, and then you actually realize that beyond the platonic relationship, there is passion involved, and normally those relationships they really last long, because you end up falling in love, and you don't know how you fell in love.
Mm. And there's something that is very interesting with what you just said now, because I realized that falling in love actually can be explained, because what you are talking about, you're not talking about just falling in love, like you just fall into love. So it's something that was built up and culminated into a very passionate, intimate, and relationship.
Commitment. I like that comment, because you see, each and every person has got what I'll call a template about the type of a man that you want or the type of a woman that you want. Let me give you an example. For example, if you had a girlfriend, for example, and that girlfriend was family centered, everything was about a family, or friend centered, everything is about friend and you didn't like it, or maybe she was church-centered, everything is about church, it's about church and blah blah blah, or money-centered, she always wants money from you, she wants you to buy airtime and blah blah blah, and you don't want, or maybe you are a woman and you meet this woman, this man, And this man, he drinks a lot, he's friend-centered, he's a mama's baby, he can't actually make a decision without going to his mother and the like. And then from there, you start, you know, developing a template of the type of a person that, of the type of a man that you want. And then once you meet Stan, you know, you'd actually realize that this is a template that I've been looking for. And you can't resist that template. You know, that's why, you know, some people become actually unfaithful to their spouses because they've got this mental template. And then all of a sudden you meet vision and you realize that this is something that I've been looking throughout my life. Something that I've been looking, here is it now.
Dr. Mabila Mathebula, we've got an SMS, right?
Yeah.
Now, somebody says his template is that he loves... at least to be in love with people that have been hurt before.
Yeah, well, that is his template or a template, and we can't say it's wrong, you know, because maybe he relates to them, you know, because he has been hurt and then now he's attracted to those, you know, that's a template, and you can't say a template is wrong, but that's your own template.
And that is his preference, right? Okay, yeah. but in this case, it's either him or her because it's not signed.
Yeah, it's not signed. Yeah, that's the template. That's what I'm saying. Each and every person has got that template.
So, Dr. Mabila Mathebula, let's look at young people like today, for instance. Does it matter whether you set your sight so high in your template or... You just have to be a bit moderate about it.
No, a template is not something that you design. Something that is designed for you.
Oh, okay.
You know, as I said to you, you are a stand and you go out with this woman, you know, the first woman, and then she's friend-centered and you don't like that thing. Or maybe she takes a lot of alcohol and you don't like it. Or maybe she's not ambitious, she doesn't want to read books and you don't like it. And then all of a sudden you meet this woman, she loves book, she loves reading, she loves radio, she loves this thing. And you realize that, you know what, you're the person that I've been looking for. Now, a template is not something that you design. It's something that has been designed for you through your own experience.
There are discussions that goes on around maybe people of the same age who will ask themselves to say, what type of a woman are you looking for, or what type of a man are you looking for? And in most cases, you will find that some, especially with young women, they will say, no, I will be married to a doctor or to a lawyer and nothing else.
Yeah, well, it's a very good question and a very good point. I think one thing about this being young, you tend to be very, you know,
ambitious, maybe.
You have this fantasy about life where you think that you control life. But once you have actually gone through experience or some experience in your life, you just realize that, you know, you are not the one who controls life, but life controls you. Such a person, you might actually have said, she might have said that, I don't want to go out with a woman who has no children. And then 30 years down the line, you realize that such a man is actually has married a woman who's got 7 children. Now, when you are young, you think that you are controlling life. But when you become, you know, matured, you realize that life controls you.
Which explain template, because that template might be what, like you said, it is designed for you. These are fantasies, are things that somebody can perhaps wish for. But then you find that when you meet somebody, it is the person who actually fit into the template that was created by you, by the universe.
Yeah, absolutely. Because when you are young, you go for what I call the shopping list syndrome, where you tell God what you want. I want a slim woman. I want her educated. I want her to come from a middle-class family. I want her to speak stylistic English. I want her to speak English to be admired, not to be heard, and then all those things. That now, but throughout life and through experience, you realize that, well, that thing is not there in your life, you know? And then you have got something different, and then you have developed a template. You know, a template has been developed for you, and then you realize exactly what life wants out of you.
Very interesting, because previously we also spoke about various issues with regard to the friendship and the relationships. Now, I just want us to stick to the relationship between opposite sex, right? Now, there are times where you find that there are problems that are there in a relationship. And there are questions that you actually ask previously. And one of the questions was, when there are problems in the relationship, will be, how did we get there to this mess? What was the purpose of our relationship? And did we set our goals? Did we agree on the dispute resolutions? And also, did we create a room to discuss openly how we want to be loved? And did we have a crisis management plan? As one of those things that can be able to help with the relationship. So when will be the best time to start having those discussions, especially for people that just fell in love now?
Yeah, well, a relationship should be purpose-driven.
Mm.
You know, where you discuss openly. For example, what is our vision? You know, where are we going in this relationship?
Mm.
And then you need to have also the values that underpin such a relationship, such as honesty. We need to be honest, you know, within this relationship, you know. And then when I feel sad, I need to tell you that, you know, today I'm not feeling well. When I'm excited, I need to tell you. I must actually tell you exactly how I feel. You know, those are the values that underpin the relationship. You must not be afraid of your partner, or your partner should be afraid of you. It should be an open, you know, an open forum. And then, firstly, the way we run companies with missions and say, what is the mission for this relationship? You need to establish that mission. You know, how do you want to be loved? Like, for example, a woman would actually say, when we're in public or when we go out, I want you to hold my hand. You know, that's a need, you know? And then that's what, you know, that's what she wants. For example, if we have got an argument, you know, let's go into the bedroom and
discuss it and sort it out. Yes.
Yeah, we don't want, you know, our problems to be heard overhead, you know, when we've got a heated debate, you know. And those are the issues that we need to discuss, and you discuss them when you are sober. It's like, for example, a person who doesn't actually tell his wife or his girlfriend that, you know, you love her, you know, like vision. And then, but when you are angry, you start actually expressing your, you know, your love to your love. I don't want to say about your rata. You know, you know what you are saying right words, but in a wrong tune.
Exactly. Now
you are using a wrong platform to express love. You know, I don't want to say about your rata. You know, but under normal circumstances, why didn't you actually tell her that you love her? You know, now these are the issues that you need to sort out.
But there's one thing that I cannot emphasize it more, Dr. Mabila Mathebula. Did we create a room to discuss openly how we want to be loved? Because it just resonates with what you were just saying now. Because if it's an open relationship, the one that you are explaining, then it should be able to have those controls that we put in place to say, we should have some kind of mechanism that we use to resolve problem. One of the examples that you made is, you know, maybe to go to the bedroom so that we discuss this thing, you know, without now trying to squeeze in issues that are not part of the discussion, as you explained, you know, which was not going to help with anything and which is not actually necessary at that particular point in time.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, in future we are going to discuss John Gray's book, Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus, you know? And then at times you have got planetary issues at play here. You know, at times when men are going through hell, or maybe you have got a work-related problem, you don't want to discuss it with your wife. You want to go into a cave, you know, and deal with that problem. But with women, in terms of their own planet, you know, they want to ventilate, they want to talk about it. This is my frustration and blah, 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 you know. But you need to understand the planet, you know, the planets. Once your wife understands that today's 10 is in the cave, you know, she lives in the cave until you come out, you know? Mm. And after you come out of the cave, then that you can actually discuss. But when a man is in the cave, he said, today, you know? No, that's the problem. We need to understand the planetary issues.
Because sometimes there are issues that depend on the environment, because some of the environment are not suitable for such discussions, I suppose, Dr. Mathebula.
Yeah, like for example, Stan, if I could actually say something. At times you have got your own frustration as my friend, and also I've got my own frustration with it. But when I've got a frustration, I just pick up the phone and say, Stan, this is what I'm going through. And my wife does not even know. You know, also you do the same. You know, I say, this is what I'm experiencing, blah, 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 blah. You know, that's what actually happens in your, you know, in our own planet, you know. And then, you know, at times you need to actually understand that. It's very simple. There are things that you are not going to tell your wife, hey, today I'm frustrated, my boss, and blah, 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 blah. You just actually bottle up and say, well, let me actually put a brave face. You know, and then the planetary issues, you need to understand them. As I'm saying to you, next time we're going to talk about, you know, how do we deal with, you know, the two planets.
We also need to talk about the state of affairs, especially for men to be able to live longer in this life as well, Dr. Mabila Mathebula.
Yeah, that's why next week we are going to talk about Tatem Kulu, because Tatem Kulu was more than 8 years when he passed on and the like. And then he had more wisdom, you know, he had more wisdom about women and that knowledge. He actually passed it on to us. And then we are not going to keep it, but we are going to pass this knowledge on to other men so that they become better men. Because at times you think that when now you have got your own ego, you are a man, and they're like, only to find that you are destroying your own relationship. Now you need to be empowered with knowledge so that you actually understand exactly where we are coming from. Because as I'm saying to you, men are from Mars, women are from Venus. Now there's this confluence of two planets, and where there's confluence of two planets, there's going to be conflict, and you must know how to solve the conflict and how to manage the conflict.
So let's talk about today we have diverted a little bit. Do we have anything in our cabinet?
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do, and then we have got a quote from George Bush when he was inaugurated as the president of the United States. Not George Bush Jr., but George Bush Sr.
Okay.
And then he said, "I take as my guide the hope of a saint in crucial things, unity; in important things, diversity; and in all things, generosity." Those code.
That's actually very powerful. Eh?
and then we have got another quote from Calvin Coolidge. Calvin Coolidge was the 33rd president of the United States. And as I'm quoting this, I'm not reading anyway.
I can see that, yes.
Yeah, I'm not reading. And he says, "Nothing in the world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful people with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone are omnipotent." Close quote.
The world is full of educated derelicts.
Now, in other words, you are not going to succeed because you are talented. You know, you are not going to succeed because you are gifted or you are a genius. You are not going to succeed because you are educated. You are only going to succeed because you are determined and persistent.
Yeah, interesting. You know, the word derelict vision. I see vision is stunned with that, with those quotes.
Yeah, no, it must be. It must be.
You know, the world is full of educated derelicts.
Yeah, I can send the quotations to you so that you can memorize them as well.
Yes, please do, Dr. Mabila Mathebula. Dr. Mabila Mathebula, thank you so very much. We know that you were ready, willing, and able to come to the studios, but unfortunately, due to circumstances that are beyond the scope of our control, it could not happen. Because you see, Eskom took our power just a little bit, and the backup was not really working. And it was a bit of a disappointment. But I do believe that next week, we are going to be together.
Yeah, but well, we don't have to worry about Eskom, because it is said that crisis is an opportunity riding in a dangerous wind. Mm. You know, because of this crisis, I had an opportunity to be given more free time. And I think our listeners are also enjoying at what we are saying. Now, the whole crisis turned into an opportunity. I couldn't have even wished, you know, Vision's girlfriend a happy birthday had I been there, you know, on I would have actually spoken to him, you know, on the side. But I think I like this crisis, because it has created so many opportunities for us.
Yes, a lot of opportunities.
Dr. Mabila Mathebula is doing the SWOT analysis as you speak. Yes, Dr. Mabila Mathebula, thank you so very much. We really appreciate your coming through.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm at home, and I wish this program could last forever. But you know what? I'm leaving not because I want to, but I'm leaving because I have to.
We feel it. We can also feel it ourselves. We also didn't want to stop talking. But because today we are playing you out with a song called Feel It from the album called Fear, Love and War by Killer Army.
Not that I don't love you. You know how much I do. Yeah, Killer Arm. This one here's for the people. The families living in the ghetto. Baby.